All right, welcome back inside our Proactive Newsroom. And joining me now is Zarko Meseldzija. He's the CEO of RecycLiCo Battery Materials. And Zarko, welcome back. Nice to see you again.
Thanks for having me.
So big news out from the company talking about a facility that you're going to build. And we'll talk about that in just a second. But maybe remind everyone about the technology that you possess and what it is you're hoping to do with that technology.
Yeah, RecycLiCo is a battery materials company focusing on recycling and upcycling waste lithium-ion battery materials. So recovering the lithium, nickel, manganese, and cobalt for the reintegration back into manufacturing new lithium-ion batteries and creating that closed loop process.
I know you've taken a lot of time to get to this particular point. We're about to step into a facility to do just that. And that's what the announcement is about today with a company out of Taiwan. Tell me a little bit about Zenith Chemicals and what it is that you'll be doing with them.
Yeah, well, I mean, to start, I really couldn't be happier to see our commercial strategy coming together. With the announcement of this 50-50 joint venture with Zenith, this is going to be our first commercial lithium-ion battery recycling plant, adopting our technology. And it will be built in Taiwan, where Zenith currently has existing land, infrastructure, and labor resources. And is also part of a world where, I would say battery technology and battery manufacturing is quite mature and very advanced there. So it's a good market to be in and a good market to be nearby. But the plant itself will be built with an input capacity of about 2,000 tons per year, and that'll be of battery waste material such as black mass, and it is estimated to cost $25 million. Now, just to put this in context, this scale-up is approximately about 12 times the scale-up of our demonstration plant here in Vancouver, and this actually gives me confidence in the scale-up of this commercial plant, compared to projects I've seen in the past where, scale-ups are 100x, and this tends to run into all sorts of engineering and construction complications that, came with so many unknown unknowns that at the bigger scale, you didn't really recognize during that small scale testing.
So does this allow you then to, you mentioned 2000 metric tons per year, is the ability to scale up if you need to scale up, or if you're at that point where things are going well, you can stay there? How does the process work, or will that be decided in sort of the design of the building?
Yeah, I mean, we're really determined kind of where the market is, and taking that 2000, right? When we look at our business model, we look at, really bespoke a method of taking our technology and, whether it's this plant is 2000 tons per year and through its commercial success, we sign on with other multiple JV partnerships. All right. Because at the end of the day, that is our business model. It's about taking our technology and bringing it into multiple markets, allowing that wide adoption of our technology. So maybe the demand in this market is 2000 tons per year, but in another market, it's 20,000 tons per year. But in these stages, will I, scale up on a modular basis, allow for that growth and to match what the market needs, not to build the plant and expect to get the supply, but, having a better understanding of where the supply is going to come from and where's this product going to go to. And then just to put this in context, right, like we signed an MOU with Zenith in February 2022, and we've been working together that whole time to validate our process, to qualify our recycled products, such as the cathode precursor. And we've done this with a well-known battery materials company. And they've looked at our product. They've looked at the physical characteristics, the electrochemical characteristics. They've tested it and compared it to other commercial products. And they're really impressed. We even had news where we outperformed commercial products when we compared our material and lithium-ion battery cells. So, what I'm trying to say is this JV was not something put together in a hurry, but really it was a thoughtful decision and negotiation that's, given the positive response that we've received from the analysis of our process and materials. And this is what's going to continue being ongoing, right? We're definitely quite busy, even with current demonstration plant work, sending products to other companies. And there's quite a bit of work to do in getting this JV up and going, but it's all an exciting time. And I see, you know, the first JV is first in anything is always the hardest. And I think from there, we'll grow into other markets as well.
So Zarko, tell me a little bit more about this company and sort of how this deal is going to work between the two.
Yeah, well, Zenith specializes already right now, and they have an existing facility, and they specialize in the production of nickel-based chemicals. So, you know, they make products such as high-purity nickel sulfate that actually goes into the lithium-ion battery supply chain that's sold to different cathode companies to be used to make make these products. So they already have a background knowledge and customers in the lithium-ion battery space. And as well, some of their partners like Hanwha and Central Glass also bring, you know, expertise and a specialization in the greater lithium-ion battery market that will hopefully support this joint venture. Mm-hmm. And then as part of the agreement, like I said, you know, it is 50-50. There is the equity split between the JV. So RecycLiCo will receive its 50% equity of the JV company, as well as a royalty on the net product sales. Our 50% split is 10%. We receive a 10% interest for our bringing in our technology into the JV, and then 40% of that will be cash, which currently the company is in a good cash position to see this through. And then as we consider other multiple JVs, you know, we'll expand and look at where those needs are in the future as well.
All right, we'll leave it there. Zarko, thank you so much. Congratulations on this pretty monumental moment for the company. So appreciate your time.
Thanks, Steve. Appreciate it.
All right, there's Zarko Meseldzija. He's the CEO of RecycLiCo Battery Materials.